good weed, bad bitches, good weed, bad bitches, good, good weed, but bad bitches, good weed, bad bitches.
I got it all in here. I got it.
Good, Lisa. Oracle Stadium.
Yeah, yeah, man, it's the homie Hood Legend back with another vlog. Here to recap that motherfucking battle that just happened between K-Shine and motherfucking Rum Nitty on Gnome 9. I would have had a motherfucking earlier vlog, but I was in fucking Cali, smoking the good bud, chilling, walking around Oakland. I thought I seen fucking Paz. I don't know, it could have been him in the club. I don't fucking know. But anyway, this was a fucking fire battle. The whole fucking car was like action packed. And like, this was the fucking battle of the night. This right here was the battle of the night between K-Shine and Rum Nitty. Like, even though like Nitty slipped up in the third, this still was the battle of the night because he got it back and was able to do what he needed to do in that third. But we're gonna get to that in a little bit. But anyway, Nitty starts the fucking battle off. Nitty goes, you know what I'm saying? Nitty starts off, he said, we gonna end all this Walmart shit when I get the once I get the Target interview. Whew, that was crazy. Once I get the Target in the interview, that was crazy. Anybody heat shine through a thermoscope, that was crazy, you know what I'm saying? Like, then Nitty start talking about the T-Rex. He was a little T-Rex, then DNA reinvented him. Then he slid up like a dancer and took twerk move. Whew! That was fire. Basically, the first round, Nitty came out like crazy intensity. Shy knew he had to match that intensity, but Shy won the coin toss. So he knew that he was going to come out with his best shit for the first round. So then Shy goes the fucking first round. Shy says, I come to kill a nigga, and y'all go give me rum? Tequila? Rum? Oh my God, that was fucking fire. Then the nigga Shy keeps going on. He says, Put down rum like I'm staying sober, or throw up rum like a hangover. Oh my fucking God. This nigga Sean was fucking wigging in the fucking first round. Like, this nigga was saying tape everywhere, listen to my artists. Like, that was crazy. Motherfucking Jay Prince Jr. was in the motherfucking building for this battle on stage. He was fucking like cringing his face up for almost every bar that Shy did, even some of the shit that Nitty did. This was clearly the battle of the night. A lot of niggas is saying Sue Surf and motherfucking Geechee Gotti was the battle of the night. It was a good battle, but it did not clearly stand up to the time that this fucking battle was right here. K-Shine and Rum Nitty, these guys showed out. Both of them came up, they came prepared, they had three rounds. Even though Nitty slipped in the third, they still had three rounds. So I like I gave Sean that first round because Nitty came out. He had a lot of material. Sean had a lot of material, but clearly Sean's shit was better. Sean 1-0 going into the second. Then the second round comes. Like, both of these niggas is still fucking wigging. Like, I got notes in here. Like, the second round, like Nitty, the 7.62. That's all you need to ask. That's all you need for an AK? Oh my gosh, that was crazy. Like, the Guardian Angel, that was crazy. The Dropbox Zip line was crazy. The Mopstick McDowell's line was crazy. Nitty had a lot of motherfucking material in this second. Shine could not match this motherfucking material in the second. I don't give a fuck what Shine did in the second. It was not standing up to Nitty shit. He had the Belly shit, the Keisha from Belly shit. That was crazy. The pink thinner shit, that was crazy. This nigga went stupid. It's clearly that Nitty is the best puncher in the game right now over Av. Like, it's crazy. You know what I'm saying? So then Shine goes the second round. Like he said, the eye for eye leaves the world blind. All this shit. Body in the trunk, Ray Caruth, DUI, no drive with rum. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, walk off on tour like a faithful nigga. Whew, that was crazy. Then the Toy Story ball was crazy. To infinity. Oh my God. Shine wild out the second round, but hey yo, bro, it was not enough. It was not enough. Nitty spazzed that second round, so I gave the second round to Nitty. It's 1-1 going into the third. Then Nitty goes. The first half of his third round is fire. Even the second half is fire. But in between both of those parts, he has a little slip up. He's trying to get it together. He's just trying to rhyme stuff. Oh, cat, hat, rat, set. And he's trying to remember his bars. Clearly, it was a choke. So by default, Nitty, you lost that round, even though the shit was fire. I cannot give you that round. But your material still was fire. When you got it back, you got the crowd back on your side. Like, this was crazy. Like, so basically, I give you a round like a motherfucking 7. But you choked, my nigga. You had fire material. So this Shine goes. Shine does not drop off a fucking round in this fucking battle. From the first to the second to the third, Shine is consistent. Both of these niggas is consistent, but with that choke in the third, it's by default. I cannot really, I can't match up the bars and give Nitty the third round because he choked clearly. Like, by default, it is a win to Shine 2-1. This was still the battle of the night. Sue Surf and Geechee did not have this intensity in the battle. It was not a back and forth like this right here. This right here was back and forth all 3 rounds. I can sit here and watch this battle all over again 10 times. It has replay value over and over and over again. So that's why I gave this battle of the night. K-Shine, Rum Nitty. But anyway, it's the Homie Hood Legend. Don't forget, subscribe to the channel for all your latest news, updates, and content in the world of battle rap. I'm out.